We're here for another episode of World Pro Ski Tour Race Breaks. Today we're sitting down with Tucker Marshall. How's it going, Tucker?
Oh, it's going great. Thank you for having me on. This is, you know, the most exciting part of my summer so far.
We're happy that that's how you feel. Thank you for thinking that this is so exciting.
I'm not sure if that says more about my life than World Pro Ski Tour.
Fair enough. All right. Athletes are always working toward building their personal brand. So how have you built your personal brand as a professional ski racer?
Building out my brand started quite a while ago. It started my video blog.
Cool.
In the house before Instagram and everything, really. I think we had MySpace, which was great. it kind of just started pretty organically. You know, I knew I was doing unique things just by traveling the world and going to incredible places. And you know, skiing was obviously my gateway to all that. I just wanted to share with the world. I didn't really know what a video blog was. I didn't, you know, watch Yoon's blog or anyone else's, but I kind of just had a video camera that I decided it was a good time to start filming stuff and making vlogs. And I started out pretty not great, but over the years I've acquired better equipment and turned it into more of a passion of mine. So that's kind of how it started. Got a website, tuckermarshall.com, if you want to go check it out.
Yeah.
And also, I knew I was a young kid going through tough times, and I just really wanted to share those tough times. That was important to me, to like not have your stereotypical social media, my life is amazing. I really wanted to show people that, like, yeah, life can get you down sometimes, but you can get out of it. This is how I picked myself up, and I wanted to share that story. So that's kind of how it all started.
I mean, you kind of dated yourself there with calling out MySpace, but
if anyone wants to know how old I am, yes, MySpace thing and Facebook was the new cool thing to do.
Has it led to anything else beyond being able to share your story? Did it allow you to connect with other brands or bridge out beyond the skiing community? Were you able to connect with the general public more because you had this video platform for other people to watch?
I would say the most way it's kind of gotten me to branch out beyond the race program is just I took that, you know, wanting to show my life and my stories with the camera kind of a step further. And you know, I do mostly videos and some photography, so people see that stuff, and just me honing my craft by just doing it over and over again, that's allowed me to, like, just, you know, go into other businesses, and it has been a cool process because it is something I'm passionate about. And as far as reaching out to companies, mostly sponsors at this point, right? Like Sync is a great sponsor of mine, and not just me, you know, asking them for money or gear. It's you know, receiving great stuff like that, but it's also me taking photographs for them and making videos for them. So it's really beneficial relationship, which is, you know, something I always look for.
And what a cool thing to say that you had a camera, you had an idea, you had a story, and it was a passion, and now it's evolving into another career opportunity that you can pursue with your media company. So that's awesome. Congratulations. As a young athlete, as a young ski racer, which skiers did you idolize growing up?
So growing up, and I don't know if you've told the following here, Noel and I will be squaring off in a little trivia, which makes me nervous because growing up, I wasn't really concerned about Bodie and Darren and Eberharder and like a lot of great athletes, but the people I really looked up to growing up were my own siblings, because I have three older siblings. My oldest brother is 10 years older than I am, and then it goes 8 and 4 years. So there's definitely some space there. And growing up, I just remember following them around the mountain and trying to keep up. And then they eventually pursued their goals and went to the U.S. ski team. They all raced World Cups. My sister was in the Olympics. So it was really awesome just watching all of that happen. I just always wanted to be a part of it. And so just like growing up, I'd look to them and, you know, want to be as good as skiers and as great as they are. And, you know, I had a dream as a kid, just like, you know, when I get old enough, we're going to be the four marshals on the World Cup, four marshals in the Olympics. And that was always the dream. My arc as an athlete is, you know, still trending up, but the line is a little flatter than we would have hoped. That didn't happen. All the marshals in the World Cup a single time, but I'm hoping to, you know, have all the marshals on World Cup eventually.
That's so cool. And names like Bodie and Darren, a lot of kids looked up to those, but to have a family and to have siblings that also shared your same passion and can put you under their wing and teach you the techniques potentially before other kids have the opportunity. What a cool experience. And I'm sure all your siblings are smiling right now listening to you say that you idolize them. That's powerful. That's cool.
Yeah, it was a cool upbringing, and I guess my mom will be mad if I don't mention her too, but she's always out on the hill 24/7.
Thanks, Mom. Well, let's get to the fan question, and I want to remind everyone, whichever question Tucker chooses, that person will get their pick of World Pro Ski Tour swag. So, Tucker, take it away.
All right, this one, and excuse me, Instagram handles are always a little difficult to pronounce. I'm going to say Trey likes skiing, T-R-E likes skiing. He said, what's the best part about racing for so long? Any tips to having a long-lasting career? Yeah, I like that question. I'll take the first part. What's the best part about racing for so long? I don't know. Skiing is just something that's, you know, I'm obviously passionate about. I don't think that you can be in a sport for so long without having that passion. For anyone wondering how long my space was, that means I'm turning 30 this summer, which is a big number. And it's like, you know, for the past few years, I've obviously thought about retiring. When you're in this long turn and you like, you laid over, feel that feeling, and you have one of those runs, like, I think anyone who's had those runs like knows that that's the best part about ski racing.
It's a hard feeling to replicate outside of skiing.
Yeah, it's just, if you're a professional at anything, and like, you know, I look at people who ice skate or who mountain bike or whatever, and it's like, I wish I knew what that felt like. And then you kind of think, well, I do, like, that's the feeling of nailing a perfect long turn. That's a really cool feeling. I think the reason I keep on coming back is I'm not the best I can be. I know that. I know I still have a lot to learn.
So what tips do you have to continue to pursue that passion for others, or to have a long-lasting career?
Obviously, you have to be healthy. My brothers and my sister, they all retired because of an injury. Those are all things sort of out of their control. For now, just keeping strong. And also, if you really love it, if you really want to do it, just keep stoking that fire. Keep on doing things that inspire you as a skier. If you find that it's time to move on, then it's time to move on. But yeah, I don't know. I guess I just haven't reached that point yet.
Very cool. Well, Tucker, thank you so much for hopping on with us. It was an awesome conversation. We really appreciate it. And yes, we will see you and Nolan next week squaring off in 3-2-1 trivia.
Awesome. I appreciate it. Look forward to seeing you next week. And try to get some questions about my siblings. I might have a chance against Nolan.
Sounds good. All right. Take it easy, man.
All right. See ya.